Welcome to Business Conversation, and today we're handling something that everyone seems to want to do, but no one seems to be doing it correctly or properly, which is agribusiness. And there's a very big difference between the whole aspect of agriculture and agribusiness. So that's what we'll be looking into. You've mentioned something about Kitale, and we've mentioned something about some regions producing some of the best avocados, for instance, even though they're producing other crops. One of the things I've also come to realize that it's quite a hindrance when it comes to the youth getting into the farming space is the information you're talking about, if I may combine the two, is many do not know alternative crops. For instance, one day I was doing my research and I realized sugar beet. The sugar beet tuber produces sugar as well. Mm-hmm. You know, produces, and it can grow in mumias very well.
Yeah. Even stevia. Rwanda is doing stevia. Yeah.
It can grow, and those are things that if you go and start telling a farmer, by the way, you can earn even more money.
By doing this.
Because sugar beet, I mean, a sugar beet can really produce, yeah. You know, it can really grow to a big tuber, yeah. You know, yes, and produce a lot. And sugar is just one of the byproducts. And then the most interesting thing is you can literally have cottage industries that can produce the sugar itself instead of taking your sugar cane to the mill.
Yes.
Yeah, so you can, because, I mean, you have, farmers there have chunks of land.
Yeah.
You know, my mom comes from Mumia, so it shall go for me. There are pieces of land until your eye cannot see anymore. Sugar. From left to right, everywhere. You can disappear in it. If you're dropped in the middle, you'll get lost.
Yeah.
So I'm just sitting down and imagining. And you'll find that, for instance, that is owned by four farmers. Mm-hmm. You know? So you find all these four farmers, for instance, all of them having 2,000 acres. Okay, planting something like sugar beet, all of them, they have the capacity and the capability to actually come up with a cottage industry that can not only produce sugar beet, but process.
Yeah.
You see, and they can be able to have the full return, the full circle of their
credit market.
Yes.
But, mm-hmm. Gentlemen, one thing, we need to appreciate the guys who developed a master plan for this country. Because if you hear of JKUAT, that is Jomo Kenyatta University of and Technology. Egerton initially was known for agriculture. That's all it was. So if we go back to the master plan of this country, we have ADB, one of the development banks that actually funds people to do this. We have AFC, the Agriculture Finance Corporation, that actually supports these people. So what needs to be done is, let's go back. Okay? If JKUAT can produce guys who are doing agriculture, focus on agriculture technology. Egerton, focus on farmers. Okay? This, because I always say there's no point of studying IT at Egerton. I'll be bashed the moment this program goes on air, but there's no point of studying IT at Egerton.
Let me add, and maybe we are in this, we'll really be bashed together. But let me add this. So we are producing all these people with the arts courses.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying, what opportunities are you creating for them, mm-hmm. for now and can grow with them in future? It's just, for many of them, it's a lost cause.
Yeah. No,
I agree with you totally.
Our parents want us to have a degree. We need to accept that. So universities ended up becoming highly commercialized. Okay, if JKUAT can produce guys who can come up with machines to even do milling and all that, I know they have the capacity. Egerton can do that. We're in a period of COVID, okay? We don't have onions in this country. Guys are struggling to get onions. We used to get them from TZ. The border is closed. Very soon, a piece of onion, if not currently, is going to go for 15, 20 shillings. We'll start crying the way it's expensive. Okay, yet, just take a drive to Isinya, those areas. You can grow. Yeah, you can grow onions. You can grow tomatoes.
In fact, like Tok Tok should, okay, I have a way, I think, maybe it has always been like that when it came to understanding the agricultural master plan. But look at it this way. I think there's a way we can drive focus in the way the agricultural master plan is, that I'm not sure about it, I've read it, but sometimes it's more of experience and understanding. Ukambani can become the fruit basket, fruit basket of Africa. Forget countries like Egypt that produce so much fruits, yet they're just lying on a small corridor along there. Ukambani can produce the best fruits in the world. Look at unsigned rice, quality. There are some fruits here which you don't even need to do anything, and the taste is amazing. So a place like the region we call Ukambani, if it's focused directly into agriculture, but specifically fruits, you name them, there's no fruit that can't grow in that area. And if that, say, support with infrastructure, the back part which we are all saying is agribusiness, processing, and just process one step. Like the Makueni plant that is producing for mangoes. There are all these other fruits which can be done, and we can increase the value at that point. That's Ukambani. Assume you go to the Rift Valley parts where you grow maize. That part can produce the best maize, but everything should be centered around making sure that maize is of the best quality. And then when it comes out, the market is ready to receive it. Again, the same way you said, the Mumias area, Muhoroni area, that land is totally wasted when you grow. It's warm. Temperatures range between 26, 27, 28 degrees. The soils are the best loam soils somewhere anyway. And all we are doing is planting sugar or meat. Is that the best return on that soil? But it's a generational problem. It was the easiest and simplest thing to just put on the ground.
One of the things I've come to appreciate is, for instance, let me pick Kitale. Again. Do you know Kitale can produce biodegradable plastic from maize?
But who has told them?
Exactly. The knowledge that Kanyarati was mentioning. Do you know the mangoes that we are getting from Makueni, for instance, you can produce leather using the skin. Do you know the cactus?
What type of leather again?
Leather.
Even I didn't know that, you see? Leather. Now you're keeping it to yourself for people. That's the problem.
See, that's why you're here. cactus. The cactus that is growing in Northeastern that we
put. Wild
cactus. Yeah. You can produce leather.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I saw that.
Cactus leather.
Somewhere in Peru or one of those. I saw that.
Some Mexicans, Latin American guys are doing it. You see? Again, when you think about it, when the other, you mentioned avocado. We discovered what you can do with the flesh,
the skin, the
seed, and even the skin of the seed.
Yes.
All those things, all of them are different elements that all of them can be different sectors. So for instance, we can have one person who is doing the agricultural bit of it, the planting. Mm-hmm. Okay? Then in that planting, remember, we have agronomists. Mm-hmm. In that planting, remember, we can also have a few scientists who can be able to map out your land. Because when it comes to land, different places, you'll find, like, for instance, the land that we have in Machakos County, it has about 3 or 4 different soil types. Mm-hmm. Same piece of land, but 3 or 4 soil types. So we have someone who can be able to map out that land and tell us, okay, this particular parcel of land, they do this because it has this kind of nutrients, etc.
No. From there, we have someone who can do the logistics, the transportation.
To the next person. The next person does what? Sorting. Mm-hmm. They sort, there are some who will choose, okay, sawa, we want to do export.
So this is what we'll
do. So they'll export. This is the grade we'll export. Yeah. The grade that remains, one of the biggest problems that we have in every single year, whenever there is a season of something, there's always wastage.
Yeah.
And funny enough, there's usually more waste
than what has been sent.
We don't even export. I don't even think we export even 50% of what we grow.
In 2018, we lost 70% of the produce from every angle. Look at maize, wort, fruits, and all that. We lost almost 70%.
Wow.
Do you know how much that is? Mm-hmm. Close to $4-5 billion. Yes. Of different produce.
In
not only in Kenya,
the sectors.
The study was done by our professor in the University of Nairobi. I've forgotten his name. It's around East Africa. Okay? Now, let's put it this way. I have produced oranges. Kanyarati exports oranges. You do orange juice. Okay? We need to have a situation whereby you two can actually be like one. Do you know why? So that the farmer reduces his loss. Okay? Once I bring to Kanyarati, whatever he has not taken, you take. And they still get value for my money.
Yeah. And then you'll find there's someone else now, after I have made the juice, I give them the peel, they extract the orange essence.
Yes.
Yeah.
And they do something
and
else.
And they do something else.
You
with
see,
it.
Fish. There's somebody who will eat fish. There's somebody who will take the skin and take it to a pharmaceutical company and make threads for surgery. Yeah. You see, so we need to have a situation whereby we harness all this. Kirdi, if they still do it, made some shoe out of fish skin. Okay? That was around the year 2009. That's when I was doing some work there and I saw it actually in Kisumu. Okay? We have the person who will eat fillet. Okay? That bone can be used in making something else. Okay? We have guys like Victoria produces some of the best omena. Okay? Take it. Yes. Take it. Make chicken feed. Make something
animal
else.
Feed.
Animal
it's
feed.
So wide.
So,
but guys, I think in all this, now that we know where we have come from, and I'm asking this because we all know that all these things are on the table, like the information we are saying. Mm. It's so easy to get information. Just Google,
yes.
And your friend will just produce everything you need to know.
He's always a friend.
And it's a friend for sure. Even I love Google because I just need to get in there and get the information I need to get. But the question is, even when many of us say they are farmers, how much more research are they doing themselves as a start? Asking themselves, what next?
We have what is called M-Pesa mentality. Okay?
Oh, so that's what you've called it?
Yeah. M-Pesa mentality is whereby Odipo here opens an M-Pesa shop. Tomorrow you will open the same M-Pesa shop there.
And I'll,
yes, okay, but guys don't go and do a research, okay? Soil can produce so many things. So what you need to do is before you engage, please take your soil for sampling, okay? Then you'll see, oh, this guy can do probably wheat, okay? I can do cotton. I can do something else on the same locality. So we end up being a diverse population, okay? Because we all need each other at some point. So let us diversify, different regions to diversify what they do. Then from then on, come and do what is called a post-harvest handling. Don't let it rot there. We have cooling stores, we have all, that is all part of post-harvest handling, okay? Come, do the cooling, do everything, do the sorting, then whatever is a reject, give it to somebody who does value addition, go on, and the whole chain will benefit. Because the factor of production in agriculture is the person down there. The moment the person down there is not remunerated enough, we all lose in the chain. Yeah, so let's pay the farmer. Pay the farmer well. He's the factor of production. Okay? The moment this farmer is paid well, his laborers will be paid well. They'll like what they are doing. They'll go into more studies to see how they can add and increase yield in their place and continue. Okay? That way, we are able to actually appreciate.
Okay. Now, so I'd like us to close with talking about one of the biggest excuses I have heard over and over again when it comes to getting into farming. And, you know, we have talked about the whole aspect of understanding that knowledge is not power. You know, until you use it, you can have all the knowledge you want. We've talked about the whole aspect of culture. One of the biggest excuses I have heard over and over again is capital. Oh, manze,
I don't have money.
But one of the things I have personally experienced is that that's not even something that people need.
Capital is the last.
Yeah, you think you do, you know, but you don't need. For instance, let me give you an example. You mentioned Kiridi, you know, and other government institutions that are there. I did not know that we have so many government institutions that can be able to catalyze your processes when it comes to getting into the manufacturing space.
Mm-hmm.
Whether they have equipment or whether they have space, where you can working space or equipment. Because when you look at it, when someone wants to get into agribusiness and agroprocessing, they need two things, equipment and space. And these two can be able to get you all the licenses that you need, from your KEBS to your GS1 license, I mean barcodes, mm-hmm. to your whatnot. Because you will go to supply, for instance, to a supermarket. They'll tell you, give us your KEBS.
Yeah.
Ah, yeah. You will go to KEBS and say, I want a KEBS certification. KEBS will tell you, we want registration. You know, where are you registered? Where is your facility? Okay? So you go get the registration from the facility, any government facility.
Mm-hmm.
You tell them, I am being incubated here. Okay? They will come. They will observe, they will give their recommendations, you get your KEBS. Then from your KEBS, you go get your barcode. So you see, you have all the three documents,
yeah.
Okay? And here, you are not using your own equipment, you are not using your own space.
So you've cut your capital.
You've cut your capital even more. It's actually between 70 and even 80%,
wow.
You see. But
now that's knowledge,
yeah,
which I don't have.
Exactly. Now you see, the thing is...
If I don't know, then how many others don't have no idea?
That's the most surprising thing. I visited a county. There's a county I visited, and the facility, I went to where they have machines for food processing. Those machines were literally brand new.
Because nobody
uses. And they're gathering dust.
Yeah.
The officers there were literally begging us to come and work from that side.
Mm.
You know, move from Nairobi, come to here. Because all we do here, we don't do much, we just sit.
How many of us, even as they start the process of trying to get in agriculture, even after they have done research, go and start in one small way? Very few people.
Because they don't.
Even, let me tell you, there are people with a plot, that 1/8 which we all say, do you know it's actually enough to feed and sell to other people?
Yes.
Many of us don't even start. Why not try even the simple? Do you know there are some things, Oedipo, you probably know.
Yeah.
There are some things you can plant. You barely have any input after putting.
Like dania.
So, why?
And dania is very much consumed.
So my the question is, why aren't we starting with the small? Small things.
There are a number of mentalities.
Yes. You know, forget even the labor.
That's why I'm not even the labor.
Not even labor. In fact, I was going to take finance.
Exactly. So when it comes to, for instance, let me give you an example. I like giving, because many times people call me and ask me, hey, I have like a piece of land. What do I
do?
Mm.
And then the next thing in Akwanga, I don't have a lot of money. You see.
So to them, it's a mental block.
Hey, I don't have a lot of money. So
it's a mental block
themselves. And then I ask them, so what do you want to plant? Then they tell me, onions, you know. I hear tomatoes has a lot of money, you know, I hear cabbages. So I listen, yes, I listen, I say, okay, have you thought of dania? Then it hits someone, wait a minute. By the way, do you know a pack of dania that can be able to fill an 1/8 is less than 200 bob?
No.
But how many people can afford 200 bob? Probably all of us here.
Yes. Just 200.
Forget that. I think
so. Even, yeah. And then
it's even frustrating.
On an eighth, yes,
mm-hmm.
You will harvest about 1,500 or 2,000 batches of dania. Batches.
2,000 times a dania is probably 5 bob now.
Yes, after it's actually 10 bob. Mm. It's a batch, yeah. The batch here, shilingi kumi hivi. You know,
that's 20k from
exactly.
200 bob.
Yes. So. The water you will use, you'll probably water, depending on the area you're in, but probably 3 times a week.
Mm.
You'll probably use 20-liter jerrycans, let's say 5 in a week. And that is excess.
Yes.
How long does it take to grow?
It takes 60 to 90 days. You can start harvesting between 60 and 90 days.
And you have 20K.
Yes. So one jerrycan, you say you buy for 10 shillings.
Even
okay. Less. Or even less. Let's give it 10 shillings. Okay. Or even give it 20. Let's say 20. So every week you're spending 100 shillings on water. Okay. And that's all you need, by the way, for Dania.
That's 400 bob.
Yes.
Times
a month. So give it even 3 months. We're talking about 1200 bob.
And
plus the 200 you have spent.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That comes to give or take 2000 give or take. Okay. Then you say you put in your labor, your time cost in there. Okay. Mm-hmm. And let's say your time cost, you double it. So you have averagely used your working capital requirements is 2000. And then you say, I'm going to pay myself 1000 shillings every single month.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just saying to water.
That's 2000.
Yes. No, that's not 2000. That's 4000 every month.
Okay.
You know, so 4000. So you say, I'm going to pay myself. So that's around 12,000, you know, so 12,000 plus the 4000 comes to around 16, you know, and you've harvested those two small things, about 2000 of them. You see, you make a clean 4000
mm-hmm.
net profit.
And you have a salary in your pocket.
And you have a salary in your pocket, you know, and those are I have over exaggerated those. Right. Yes. So you
because
see,
if it's an eighth, of course, I stay probably on that land.
Exactly. You know. So you see, you can imagine if that's what you did with 200 Kenya shillings.
Mm-hmm.
You started with your seed was 200 Kenya shillings. Okay. You have paid yourself, quote unquote,
mm-hmm.
because you're taking care of the land. And if you're living there, chances are you have
mm-hmm.
the water.
Yeah.
What can you do with 4,000 shillings?
You can double the amount of the years.
Triple.
Yeah. Then now you decide on that eighth, you plant something like, let me pick a kunde, you know. But now with kunde, what you do is you do not uproot the whole crop.
You just cut
the leaves. The same way you do tea leaves.
Yeah.
Do you know you can harvest the same crop
mm-hmm.
4 to 6 times? Because you just water
yeah.
and they sprout. These things are viable because I have literally done them.
You have done them.
And it works. So it's the whole aspect of looking at what people are doing, but seeing more than what they are doing.
Yeah.
But you see, thing is, the moment you decide to do agribusiness, okay, you need to actually realize one thing. Yeah? You are the same, have the same concept as a telecom business, another business. Okay, just know you have to put in time and you have to put in capital and also be professional. Okay, that's the other thing. Then, from then on, to reduce competition, what are you doing different?
Yes, exactly. Your niche. What is your unique selling point?
What is your unique selling point? Somebody started with green tea, the tea that we used to. Guys are now doing purple tea. And all the flavored tea, you see, always go a step ahead of your competition. That highway is always very clear.
The thing you've mentioned also is when people hear farming and think capital, they think currency, money.
No.
But they neglect the power of social capital.
Yeah.
Yes.
Social capital will get you things
exactly.
that currency, money can never get you. So social capital is also very important when you think about it.
I agree with you totally. And it's the same social capital that will probably get you whatever you need from someone else. As I'm trying to get into the avocado production business, what am I looking at? I need equipment. I need to know where the avocados. But the biggest of all is what? The market. Where am I going to supply? Who am I supplying? And I've gone around with a few people that are telling me, oh, you know, this company actually buys crude. This actually, and those are local. You haven't even exported yet. So my point is, social capital is very big. But the biggest challenge we also have is, and maybe the biggest discouragement for many people, is the sale of our produce.
Brokers.
The broker system is a broken system that does not work.
I like that. Broker system is the broken system.
It doesn't work. You can't bring your tomatoes from Kirinyaga, from a whole pickup load.
Yes.
You get to Marikiti, someone says, hey, come out. Ah, umekuja karibu. Leta mzigo ni yangu. Yeah. And it's not a negotiation.
Yes.
So you leave him with your tomatoes, he decides the pricing, he sells, he adds whatever he wants, then he tells you this is what your value is. I go back.
That
and that's the truth, guys.
That happened to me.
And that's the truth. Because there's what we call the owners, and those are, and they're what we call sisi ndio wenyewe.
Yes.
People who belong, this is ours. You go to any market. And that's why there's one starting to, a market that is going to come back somewhere along Kiambu Road. I'm not too sure where. Or across the bypass there, somewhere around there.
Where people have parked.
No, not even that. There's a market that's going to come up.
Oh, okay.
For farmers. A farmer's market. No middleman.
Workers.
You come with your goods, you confirm everything, you come and you sell.
What is farmers in Kiswahili? Wakulima. Do you have Wakulima market?
Wakulima market, it's there. It's been taken over. It's now broker's market.
That's it. I'll tell you this. Some bit of brokerage is good, eh?
We agree.
Thank you.
It reduces the burden for me to go and look for
you.
I agree.
Because a typical farmer in Muhoroni who does not have a truck.
But let me cut you short. But do you know why we have to use the middleman? Because people, me, I grow tomatoes, my neighbor grows tomatoes, the other neighbor grows tomatoes. But do you know what they are doing? We're all relying on someone else
to sell.
To come.
Farm and
we have not gone to collect. We have not gone through our research. We have not tried to get a solid market. We have not tried to, as a group, live. No, we are so selfish. Mimi na zangu. Zimewache ziende. So why don't those group of farmers come together and ask us, we all agree there's a problem. What next?
Do this. Solution is one, contracted farming. Mm-hmm. Don't just go take your seed to the ground before you know where you're taking. Agriculture works in reverse. Agriculture
is market first.
Yes, farming. Yes.
In fact, please repeat that word so that everyone can hear.
It works in reverse.
And what is reverse?
Reverse is get the market first.
And then come this.
Then come
and
this.
Then,
because when you get the market first, you know what the market wants.
Mm.
Okay?
And I learned that from you.
Yeah, I'm the one who taught you that.
Yes.
Thank you.
You take the credit. You can patent that word.
I can patent it. So get the market. You will know the market wants a certain type of tomato. Okay? Then it takes this duration to grow. I need this amount of capital.
And it grows here.
Okay? Most contracted farming agreements are such that the guy who's given you the contract will most of the time give you the seed. You see, because he wants quality, he'll give you the seed. So after he has given you the seed, you realize your capital injection on the seed has gone out. Okay, probably the land is yours. You're not leasing. So land out. Okay, then labor readily available. Okay, plant. It's planted this way. Then this guy who's given you a contract will give you what is called agronomic support. He'll send his agronomists there to check on your farm. They come check on your farm, it's part of the contract because you want something quality. Him, he has the market. Okay? So you are his supplier. Simple. Then after you agreed on a price, so you come home and do your calculations and say, I'm selling this kilo at 60 shillings. My cost and all that is probably 45 shillings. I'm making a good 15 bob per kilo. Do I want this? Yes. Let me do it. Then engage. Simple. There's no day a broker will come to your farm gate. He doesn't. Because this guy who has contracted you will come pick this produce. He needs it. Yeah.
Especially if it's for an export market.
Yeah, if it's for an export market. He'll cut off the broker. But if you decide you're going to plant, I'm telling you, you'll deal with enough brokers.
You know, they
because the brokers know the market.
The interesting thing.
In fact, they're the ones who've done all the research.
Yes.
Which you should be having as a farmer.
Yes.
Which they carry with them.
Yeah.
We should have a season two of this and talk about it. Because you know, everything we have just mentioned is a topic on its own.
Yeah.
It's a show on its own. So we'll pick it up from there. But what you have mentioned is interesting enough. Do you know that's how God created the earth?
Mm-hmm.
You see, God knew already on the sixth day what he was going to do.
Mm-hmm.
He was going to bring up man.
Yeah.
Okay? But he needed to prepare a few things before man came into play. That's why he created the sky, then the firmaments, as they call them. That's why he created the water and then the fish. That's why he created the
the land and then the plants, mm-hmm. and so on and so forth. There was always a prerequisite too. So he looked at what he was going to do on day six, and then he said, what do I need
for to this start guy with? To
yes,
be,
what is
my so that this person is
exactly.
has everything he needs.
Exactly.
So God and started from the contract.
Yes, God started from the contract.
That is business conversations.
Agribusiness and agri-processing in terms of farming, not just agriculture. Catch up with you next time. Odipo G, Nick, and Kanyarati.
This is Clean Money TV.